blog Mica Popovic, June 23, 1923, December 23, 1996, was a Serbian painter, experimental filmmaker and one of the major figures of the Yugoslav Black Wave. Mica Popović was born on June 12, 1923 in Loznica. He finished grammar school in Belgrade. After the Second World War, most of which he spent in Belgrade working at odd jobs, he enrolled the Academy of Fine Arts in Belgrade in 1946. He studied under Ivan Tabrikovic. Together with Bada Mujlovic, Peter Omkikis, Milta Andrejevic, Lubinka Jovanovic, Kozar Bakshin, and Vera Bosikovic, he went to Zadar in 1947 and formed the famous Zadar group. After returning to Belgrade, they were forbidden to return to their university studies, as the authorities viewed the work of the Zadar group as subversive, but sometime later, they were all allowed to return except for Popović, who continued to study on his own. As a painter, Popović is best known for his informel period, 1958 to 1968, and his scenes painting, Slikarstvo Prize Aro, from 1968. Among the scenes paintings, one of the more notable ones was May 1, 1985, which memorialized events surrounding an alleged attack on a farmer in Kosovo named Jordi Martinović. He also made several films in the 1960s, two of which, Čovek iz Hrasta o Šumendili, were banned by the government for their anti-socialist content. Mica Popović was elected a regular member of the Serbian Academy of Sciences and Arts in 1986. Mica Popović went through several painting phases, the most famous of which are informel, French, informal, without form, in the period 1959 to 1969, and scene painting from 1969 to 1979. But before that, it had an interesting prehistory that is also significant for Serbian painting of the second half of the 20th century. It can be divided into several periods. Before coming to the Academy of Fine Arts in 1946, Popović was already very interested in painting. His early manifested natural need for artistic design was more seriously expressed in high school with Rista Stijović, who was his drawing teacher. At the same time, he began to visit current exhibitions organized in the Art Pavilion on Kalemegdan and in the Museum of Prince Pavle. There, he had the opportunity not only to see and get to know directly the most significant works of Serbian and Yugoslav artists, but also foreign art. Also significant was his acquaintance with the painter Svetolik Lukić, who first introduced him to painting as an artistic medium. Those two circumstances reduced Popović's interest in high school education and completely turned him to art. A serious turn in Popović's art occurred at the very beginning of his studies at the academy. The conflict between the two ideologies of the professors of that school, those who fervently advocated the new ideology of socialist realism and others, the older ones who remained silently committed to the pre-war aesthetics of poetic realism and intimism, did not suit the young painter who saw that something was wrong, but then he didn't understand what. However, he soon realized that the school's work program did not suit him at all, and he persuaded his classmates to go to Dalmatia on their own initiative before the end of the school year and, after a short search, to stay in Zadar for a few months. That's when the myth of the Zadar group, the first to emerge in the new Yugoslavia, was born. The Mediterranean light, the landscape and the freedom of mutual portraiture completely satisfied the needs of that group of painters at that moment. Filled with new creative energy, they return to Belgrade and are expelled from the academy. After the urging of their protégés in high political and state positions, all of them, except Mica Popović, were sent back to school. Today, it is difficult to guess whether such a decision helped or hindered Popović to become such a specific artist in Serbian painting that will mark his development so much almost until the end of the century. This doubt was fueled by his painstaking search for artistic expression, the searches and wanderings that Mica Popović went through during almost the entire sixth decade. There was everything in them, from ethnographic motifs to medieval painting, from old poetic intimacy to the equally anachronistic Paris school, which he was directly confronted with during several stays in that former world capital of painting art. If in Paris he was confronted with a new art that laid the foundations of informel, he was not yet creatively ready to notice it, much less to incorporate it into his own work. It was necessary for him to first get acquainted with the philosophy of Zen Buddhism, and then to practically see how informal paintings were created at the very end of the 50s in order to violently engage in what definitely marked the Serbian art of the 60s and brought it into real relations with the international flows. In historiography, Mica Popović is placed at the very top of that new wave in art painting, not only by the works he created, but also by several critical observations that gave that art the necessary theoretical basis. But, Popović once again survives a kind of saturation with informal painting practice and, with the changed political and social circumstances at the beginning of the eighth decade, begins his last adventure, scene painting. The revolutionary return to figurativeness inevitably led him to engaged painting, which as the last defense of a nation had to show the artist's clear political attitude expressed both symbolically, with a series of paintings with monkeys, and textually, manipulation, no thanks, harsh condemnation of the black wave, and the series Iron, guest workers. In the hexagonal space with friends, Zvezdan Stojković, Borislav Milović Mahiz, Dobrica Šošić, Lazar Trifunović, and Antoni Isaković, in 1970 he announced the beginning of public dissident activity, which he remained committed to until the 1990s, when he switched to the opposition in multi-party conditions. It is no coincidence that his last public appearance, already visibly tired and ill, took place just before his death in front of the rebellious students of Belgrade University in 1996. The central place of Mića Popović's entire painting oeuvre, viewed retrospectively, in all phases, was the fateful feeling of the tragedy of existence, both individual and collective.